Welcome to the Salt and Swim 3C and Salt and Swim 3C Pro training video. This video will cover installation and startup. It is provided for you to better understand our products and how they operate. The only difference between the two units is plumbing, which we will cover separately. Before beginning installation, please view the video titled Chemistry Requirements for Hayward Salt Chlorinators. Make sure to also read the installation manual and quick start guide included with the Salt and Swim 3C and Salt and Swim 3C Pro Chlorinator carefully and completely. This video is designed to serve as a quick overview and does not replace or supersede the detailed installation and operation requirements set forth in the product's owner's and installation manual. To obtain a free additional copy of the manual, please visit hayward.com. Electrical installation. Prior to installation, make sure all electrical wiring conforms to local codes, regulations, and the National Electric Code. It is important to plan where the salt system is going to be installed. The unit must be within 15 feet of where the salt cell is to be plumbed. The Salt and Swim 3C and Salt and Swim 3C Pro come factory pre-wired with a line cord and will work only with 120 volts AC, 60 hertz, single phase voltage and will pull around 3 amps. A GFCI receptacle is required for all plug-in style controllers. Also ensure the salt system is properly grounded and bonded for safety. Proper grounding and bonding should also alleviate galvanic corrosion associated with the pool structure. To power up the Salt and Swim 3C and Salt and Swim 3C Pro, simply plug the unit into a GFCI receptacle and verify LEDs are illuminated. We will now cover plumbing for the Salt and Swim 3C. The plumbing for the Salt and Swim 3C Pro will follow. After confirming the system is properly powered, turn off the breaker or unplug the cable from the GFCI receptacle. The salt cell and flow switch are integrated into one self-contained element. Salt and Swim 3C does not require gluing of plumbing and includes parts to work with both 1.5 inch and 2 inch plumbing. The cell vessel must be the very last component installed in the pool's return piping before the water returns back to the pool. The cell must always be installed after all pool equipment. It is important that it is the last piece of equipment on your plumbing before water is returned to the pool. It can be installed vertically or horizontally and requires approximately 10 inches of straight pipe at the installation location. Use the included cutting template to aid in marking and cutting the pipe. The entire cutting template must fit on the pipe, otherwise the cell vessel will not fit. Secure the template and use a marker to mark all 10 cutouts. Using these marks, cut the PVC as straight as possible for the best results. When the PVC has been cut, use a clean rag and remove any burrs that have formed. Slip the union compression rings and collars on both ends of the pipe in that order. Verify the two vessel gaskets are in place. They should be already attached to the vessel. Then hand tighten the unions. Once hand tightened, use a strap wrench to tighten an additional quarter turn. Inspect the plumbing and verify the dash marks are not visible. If visible, loosen the unions and reposition so they cover the marks. We will now cover the plumbing for the Salt and Swim 3C Pro. After confirming the system is properly powered, turn off the breaker, time clock, or unplug the cable from the GFCI receptacle. The cell and the flow switch are integrated into one self-contained element. When installing the salt cell vessel for the Salt and Swim 3C Pro, it is important that the area is well ventilated since PVC glue will be used. To install the vessel, measure approximately 8.5 inches and cut the PVC as straight as possible for the best results. When the PVC has been cut, use a clean rag and remove any burrs that have formed. Slip the unions over the pipe with the threads facing in towards the cut. Remember, if the PVC is glued without the unions in place, the plumbing will have to be cut up and downstream, which will not make for a clean installation. Prime the cut area on the pipe and inside of the tailpiece with PVC primer. Once primed, use PVC glue on both the pipe and the inside of the tailpiece. hold in place following the instructions provided by the glue manufacturer. After allowing time for the glue to dry, place the cell vessel into the plumbing and tighten the unions. After cell is installed later in this video, you can check the glue joint by running water through the pipe. Cell installation. The next step is to remove the foam protector from the Salt and Swim cell. Next, fully cover the cell pins with grease supplied with a unit. Verify that the O-ring is attached to the cell before inserting into the cell vessel. Plug in cell cap and secure with a retaining nut. Run the pump for 5 minutes or until all air is out of the system. Check for leaks, then turn the pump off. Once the cell is installed, plug the unit back in and follow the flow switch calibration that follows. After being powered on for the first time, the Salt and Swim will display a blinking inadequate water flow LED and a solid standing by LED. Keep the Salt and Swim powered for the remainder of this procedure. Now turn the filter pump on. Run the pump until full flow is achieved and there is no air in the system. Turn the filter pump off for approximately 15 seconds. With the filter pump off, the Salt and Swim should now display a solid inadequate water flow LED and a solid standing by LED. The flow switch calibration procedure is complete. You can now turn on your filter pump and begin normal operation. Let's now talk about operation. The Salt and Swim does not have an on-off switch. The unit is designed to be plugged into a GFCI rated outlet at all times. There should be no need to remove power from the Salt and Swim unless pool components are being serviced or the pool will be closed. When power is first applied to the Salt and Swim, an initialization routine will run for approximately 30 seconds. During this time, various LEDs will illuminate. This is perfectly normal and does not require any input from the user. When the routine is finished, the Salt and Swim will begin normal operation. If the water chemical levels are in the recommended range, there are two factors that can be controlled which directly contribute to the amount of chlorine the Salt and Swim will generate. 1. The amount of time the filter pump runs every day, and 2. The daily chlorine output setting on the Salt and Swim. The filter pump timer should be set so that all the water in the pool passes through the filter at least once each day. For pools with high chlorine demand, the timer may have to be set longer to generate enough chlorine. You can adjust the amount of chlorine that is generated using the plus and minus buttons on the Salt and Swim unit. The daily chlorine output LEDs will display the current setting. Push plus to increase and minus to decrease the settings. Each daily chlorine output LED represents 6 minutes of chlorine generation out of 1 hour of runtime. For example, if 6 LEDs are illuminated, the Salt and Swim unit will generate chlorine for 6 times 6 minutes, equaling 36 minutes out of every hour of operation. During this time, the generating chlorine LED will be lit. The unit will be idle for the remaining 24 minutes, at which time the generating chlorine LED will turn off and the standing by LED will illuminate. To find the optimum setting, start the operation with 5 daily chlorine output LEDs illuminated. Test the chlorine level every few days and adjust up and down accordingly. It usually takes 2 to 3 adjustments to find the ideal setting for your pool. After that, it should only take minor, infrequent adjustments. Because the chlorine demand of pools increase with water temperature, most people find they have to adjust up at the peak of summer and down during colder periods. The Salt and Swim automatically scales back to 12 minutes of output per hour if set higher than 12 minutes, when pool water drops to 50 to 60 degrees Fahrenheit or 10 to 16 degrees Celsius. This protects the unit and prevents possible overchlorination. The Salt and Swim stops generating chlorine altogether when the pool water temperature drops below 50 degrees Fahrenheit or 10 degrees Celsius. This is usually not a problem because bacteria and algae tend to stop growing at this temperature. You can override these automatic low temperature operations by switching to superchlorinate for a day. After the ideal daily chlorine output setting has been found, you may need to raise the setting when the pool water temperature increases, when there is higher than normal bathing load, or when the Salt and Swim 3C cell ages. It is important to follow the maintenance recommendations in the manual. For professional help and service, go to Hayward.com and select Dealer Locator, which you will see at the top left of the website navigation bar. Next, provide the postal code of where the system is installed, as well as 1. A search radius, 2. Pool type, 3. Product repair and service, and 4. Electronic chlorinators. Lastly, select Submit and you will see all local Hayward authorized service centers who can assist with the electronic chlorinator installation, operation, or service. To access the Salt and Swim Troubleshooting Assistant, go to www.hayward.com and click on Sanitation. Then click on Salt Chlorination. Then click on Salt and Swim 3C. You will see a list towards the bottom. Click on Salt and Swim 3C Troubleshooting Assistant. As you scroll over the different buttons on the Salt and Swim 3C control panel, you will see possible help areas. Click on the one that you feel will help. Remember to visit Hayward Pool Products at www.hayward.com along with our social media sites for helpful information about your Hayward products.